Good day to you all, and welcome back to my channel today. My name is Chukwube Madiji. In today's video, we want to look at how to detect cross-section dependence in panel data regression, and of course, how to remedy such a situation, how to correct for cross-section dependence in panel data regression. Okay, and when we say cross-section dependence in panel, we mean a situation whereby the errors or the disturbances in panel data regression are cross-sectionally correlated or dependent. Okay, that is what we actually mean. Now, it follows a normal situation that these disturbances in panel data regression are cross-sectionally independent. So that is why the assumption is that the regression, the panel data regression, becomes free of such problem when there is absence of cross-section dependence in residuals. Okay, can also call it disturbances. Okay, that is the normal situation. But then in real life, you can hardly get to such a situation where there is no cross-section dependence in disturbances in panel data regression. Okay, and what actually causes this thing? What really causes it is because of the interdependence of countries of the world. Countries are so interdependent that if anything happens in one country, it can actually affect or spill over into another country. Now, we'll give a very micro example of a citizen of Nigeria who resides in China. Okay, if this citizen of Nigeria who resides in China is working in China and earns his living in China, now chances are that this individual also sends money home to his people through what is called remittances. Now, if there's any policy in China, government policy, or any form of crisis in China that affects this particular individual or the his work, his source of living, from where he sends money home, automatically such policy or crisis will also affect those who depend on him for survival. Okay, the same thing applies to the fact that most countries are interdependent through trade and financial integration. Okay, because of that, if anything happens in one country, maybe any trade policy in one country can invariably affect another country. So let us see it on that way, how this cross-section dependence can actually manifest. Okay, now if the panel has group of firms, you will also agree with me that this group of firms are interdependent. Okay, some firms also do transactions, you know, they also engage in certain level of transaction, and that means that they are to some certain degree interdependent. Okay, and that situation can also warrant cross-section dependence in residuals of panel data regression. Now, why do we bother about this cross-section dependence? We bother about this because if we ignore it, it will render the estimator inefficient and of course produce or generate invalid test statistics, and that is why we should bother about cross-section dependence. Okay, now in testing for cross-section dependence, certain procedure has actually come up for that. We have the one of Bruce Pagan 1980 LM test. We also have the one of Pesaran scaled LM test. We also have the BFK, that is Bataji, Feng and Kao. Okay, and Co. Will I call it Kao? 2012 bias corrected LM test. Okay, we also have Pesaran 2004 CD test. Okay, all these test statistics, they also have their uses depending on the panel structure. Okay, depending on the panel structure. For instance, if we have T being greater than N, if T, that's period, is greater than the number of groups, okay, we go for Bruce-Pagan LM test. Okay, we go for Bruce-Pagan LM test. Now for the bias corrected scale, when both T and N are too large, you know, 10 to infinity, we go for that also. Now, like we have said that if T is greater than N, we go for Bruce-Pagan LM test. But if T and N are of similar magnitude, or rather if T is very small, if T is small, it follows that we go for Pesaran CD test. Okay, Pesaran CD test. Now let us operationalize this. In here we have our file set up in a panel structure from 1995 2015, giving us 20 T. Okay, and of course we have 21 T, and of course we have 20 countries. Okay, look at what we mean here. Country ID, this is country ID, so we have 1 to 20 countries. Okay, 1 to 20 countries. Now for the date, we have 1995 to 2015. This is 21. Okay, this is 21. So what do we do? First of all, we are going to estimate panel least square, the ordinary one, the one we call a pool mean group regression, panel least square, without controlling for country specific effect or heterogeneity. We are going to first of all estimate that one and correct and test for cross-section dependence. If it exists, we correct for it and go into another setting, panel setting. Now what do we do? The dependent variable here is SVI. We pick FDGDP, we pick EDGDP, we pick DISCO. Then we open them as you can open as group from where you can proceed, but let's open as equation. Now if we open as equation, here we have the setting from the dependent variable. Okay, we do not do anything on panel structure. Can you see we didn't do anything on panel option? Okay, with this we can estimate the panel least square. Okay, here no control is placed on country specific or individual fixed effect and all those things. We didn't control for that. Now you can see the result here. Now we are going to test for cross-section dependence in residual. Okay, cross-section dependence in residual. Now if we do that, we come to residual diagnostic and you can see cross-section dependent test. So if we test for that, we can see results here. You can see results here. Here we say that if T is greater than N, we go for Bruce-Pagan LM test. But then again, we mentioned that if T is because in our case here, T is considered to be relatively small. You can see that T is small. We have 21 period here, and of course you can now see that T and N, because cross-section here gives us 20, T and N are almost of same magnitude, which means that the preferred test here is the Pesaran CD test. You can see that. So in whichever case we reject the null hypothesis of no cross-section dependence in residual, okay, which means that there is that cross-section dependence exists in the residual of this pool panel least square. Okay, now let us correct this situation. So to remedy this situation or to correct it, we have two ways of correcting this situation. Okay, now we have the method of generalized least square method. Okay, if we want to correct this problem, we can use the method of the one called generalized least square method, or we can use the one that is called panel corrected standard error. Okay, panel corrected standard error, PCSE. Okay, remember, if we want to correct for cross-section dependence, we either use the generalized least square method or we go for panel corrected standard error, which is abbreviated as PCSE. Now, which one do we use given the panel structure? If T is greater than N, the generalized least square method is preferred. If T is greater than N, it means that the generalized least square method is preferred. But if N is greater than T, it means that panel corrected standard error is preferred. So let us move back. Of course, in our case, T is actually greater than N. Okay, what do? We come to this panel option and go to weight, GLS weight. We put it at cross-section SUR. SUR stands for seemingly unrelated regression. So we put it here. Okay, we do not touch any other thing. We click OK. So the result comes out again. Of course, for this very result, we can now retest for cross-section dependence. Okay, and when we do that, what do we see? We keep the observation on Pessarin CD test. Okay, we can now see that with this probability, we cannot reject the null that there is no cross-section dependence. Okay, in weighted residuals. Okay, now you can now see that. Now the second thing we are going to do is to go for fixed effect, and of course also do the same test. So this test can be done on any panel option you choose. Okay, here we want to test and fix for cross section. We want to correct for individual effects. Okay, we want to correct for it. We return this to no weight again. We estimate. What can we see? This is the result, and this result we want to also test whether there is cross section dependence in this result. Of course, we can see that we are still getting the same result, that we are rejecting the null hypothesis that there is no cross-section dependence in residuals. Okay, now how do we correct this? We return to the same procedure we used for the first option, where we said we are using the method of GLS, generalized least square method, okay, to correct or to remedy for this situation. Now we return to cross-section seemingly unrelated regression. Okay, nothing else should be touched. Result comes out here. Okay, and when the result came out, we can now retest for cross-section dependence. What can we see? We go back again to Pessarin CD test and see that with the probability value, we can no longer reject the null hypothesis that there is no cross-section dependence in weighted residual. Okay, this is the simple procedure for detecting cross-section dependence in panel data regression and how to remedy the situation. Please support my channel by subscribing. If you have not subscribed to this channel, please kindly subscribe and comment, and also share, like the video, also share. And please, like I said, you can always comment. If there's anything you want me to do, any clarification, anything at all, please kindly comment. I will respond to every comment at my spare time, but be rest assured that I will respond to your comments. Okay, thank you very much.